we are to do with Mary. She goes where she wants to go and does what she wants to do. I cannot hope to succeed with Colin's treatment if she is allowed to sneak into his rooms and disturb him. You must send her away before she undoes everything we have tried to do.
Well, I can't send her away, no. She has no one on the earth but me. Can't we keep her outside? She enjoys the gardens, I believe.
What are you doing, Archie?
I'm leaving, Neville. You have things well in hand here.
Well in hand? Haven't you heard anything I just said?
Last night, I dreamed of walking the gates of the men's garden. I saw Lily and Mary standing there. Now let's see. When we left off last night, the hideous dragon had carried the bait to his cave by moonlight. He gnashed his teeth, breathed his fire. The heath quaked, and we trembled in fear. Then I said, "Someone must save the sweet raven-haired maiden, though surely the cost will be steep." So we lads all drew lots, our insides tied in knots, and there one, and the rest went to sleep. So I picked up my scarf and I told the tale of this soul, the mouth of the cave, and I bid him come out, yea, forsooth, I did shout, "Ye fool dragon, be gone, or be paid." Thank you. since there is actually just about the time. And tell me exactly what you saw.
Everything's so still. Right. The trees are right. The earth is right. And there's this creepy kind of thing all over everything.
Like a body in a dream?
It's the most forgotten place I've ever seen. With loose gray tree branches and the dome of the trees and ropes and snakes and dead roots and leaves all tangled up all over everything. So still and cold.
What did you take off your claws and look at anything, Mary? Did you have a scrape all the way up into the bark and have a good look at him? America's strongest rose has been rotten and being neglected, and the soil is rich enough. But the spread and spread and what all the while to that wonder.